Okay, student, today we'll start to discuss about the minimum spanning tree. Okay, so minimum spanning tree, before discussing the minimum spanning tree, I'll just discuss about the tree and graph. Just as we know that ultimately what is basically the tree and what is basically the graph. Tree is basically, you know that, connected as cyclic graph. Okay, means the tree is a subgraph, you can say that contain any, do not contain any cycle, and tree with n nodes contain exactly how many edges? N minus 1 edges. Okay, and graph is what basically, graph, we know that graph with the n nodes contain less than or equal to n minus 1 by 2 edges. Okay. Next, spanning tree. Spanning tree is one of the tree that contain all the vertices, but not necessarily that it contain all the edges basically. Okay, but as I have told earlier that in previous class, that is very important topic, because examination point of view as well as for various competitive exam, because this topic have a very lots of real life provide the real solution of various real life problem. Okay, because what lots of real life problem can be mapped by on a spanning tree, and we will use this spanning tree to find out some solution of various real life problems. Okay, so what basically the spanning tree, we know as per the definition, means that contain all connect, when we have a connected undirected graph. Connected means when every node is visible from every other node. Undirected means edges do not have an associated direction. Okay, means we can move from any of the directions. Suppose we have a edge A, B. Okay, then we can move from A to B and B to A also. Okay, so then what is the spanning tree of a graph? Is a connected subgraph in which there are no cycle. Okay, so that contain all the vertices, but not necessarily that contain all the edges. For example, in that is given in the particular slide. Okay, so I just take pencil tool. This one is in the very first graph. It is showing connected undirected graph, and from here we can see that these are the different spanning tree of this graph. Spanning tree 1, spanning tree 2, spanning tree 3, and this one is the spanning tree 4. Okay, so these are the different spanning tree of this graph. From here we can see that in the left side the connected undirected graph, and in the very first graph and first spanning tree that contain all the four vertices but not contain all the edges. Similarly, there is spanning graph number 2 also contain all the vertices but not necessarily all the edges basically. Okay, so these all are the different we can find out the spanning tree from various spanning tree from a graph by just taking all the vertices but and skipping all the edges also. Okay, so I think it is clear for all of you what is basically the spanning tree. Next, this is also one of the examples through which this, you can just note down this example basically, and the right graph A, the figure of A is showing a particular graph. Okay, and B, C and D, that these are the example of the spanning tree of this graph. So by using this we can find out. So you just note down these spanning trees, the example of the graph, and then find out all possible spanning tree. These are B, C and D show the some possible spanning tree of graph A. You just have to note down in your notebook and find out some more spanning tree from this graph A, from graph A. Okay, so just note down. I'll share this slide and this video also on the YouTube channel. Okay, so you just go just write down this example and find out spanning tree. Okay, Next, we have minimizing cost. Okay, this is one of the basic requirement, and through this real life example, we can see that how spanning tree is used in various real life problems. Suppose you want to supply a set of houses, say in a new subdivision, with electric power, water, sewerage line, telephone line, to keep cost down. Okay, so you could connect these houses with a spanning tree. Okay, you just have to take houses as a vertex in a graph. Okay, vertex in a graph, and then all houses are, as we know, that not equal, are not all equal distance apart. So we just have to connect these houses by using electric power, water, sewerage lines, and telephone lines. But what we want to reduce the cost every time. Okay, so how can we map this problem on the graph? Graph theory, we just make a graph from these the collection of these house and their supply. Okay, and then find out the minimum cost spanning tree to supply these all types of facilities: electric power, water, sewerage line, and telephone line. So this is one of the example. A cable company want to connect 5 villages to their network. And cable may be optical fiber cable, electric power cable, water supply line. Okay, which currently extend to market town of 1 foot. What is the minimum length of the cable needed? Okay, so we have to require to find out the spanning tree. We just have to this one is the graph. Okay, and we'll just find out all the spanning tree, and out of these spanning tree, we'll find out the minimum cost spanning tree, because as we know that spanning tree contain all the cover all the cities as well as that provide connect all the cities also. Okay, so out of these spanning tree, we'll find out the minimum cost spanning tree, because it provide the minimum cost basically. Okay, so from here we can see that that particular topic is very important to solve various real life problems. So and basically, so as a programmer, we have to know how to write down the algorithm. We have to require to automate this problem by using some programming also. So before doing any programming or write down an algorithm, we have to require to map our problems in the form of mathematical equations or mathematical model. So we'll use set theory to represent this problem. G is a one of the capital G is a graph, that is the collection of two sets, first and capital N, that is the set of nodes, and A is the set of edges. Okay, so each is has a given non-negative length, and the problem is to find a subset T of edges of G such that all the nodes remain connected when only the edges in T are used, and the sum of the length of the edges in T is as small as possible. Okay, means these two sets we have, set of nodes and set of edges. Out of these set of nodes, we have to require to find out a subset of G that is connected at least one solution that contain minimum cost spanning tree basically. Okay, so these two algorithms are basically used to find out the minimum cost spanning tree, and that you have also discussed earlier in some subjects like in discrete mathematical structure. And these two algorithms are very important, also specified in curriculum and syllabus in your analysis of algorithms also. So there are the two basic algorithms for finding the minimum cost spanning tree, and both are based on greedy algorithms. Greedy means what? Greedy means why it is based on greedy algorithm, as we know that earlier we have discussed Knapsack problem. Knapsack problem is what, in which we have a carry bag, and we have to require to put the items that provide the maximum profit. Okay, here we are focused to we have a particular graph, and out of these graph we will select the edges that provide the minimum cost edges basically. Okay, so Knapsack problem, about in the next problem, we are greedy about to take the maximum profit items, and here we are greedy about to choose the minimum cost is basically. So ultimately, we know that this type of problem can be solved by using which approach? Greedy algorithms. Because you cannot solve this type of problem, minimum cost spanning tree, by using the divide and conquer. Divide and conquer that we have discussed earlier in quick sort algorithms, basically. But divide and conquer means we can, if we divide whole problem and sub problem and then find out the sub whole solution, this approach cannot be used in minimum cost spanning tree or find out the minimum cost spanning tree, basically. Okay, so we will discuss this problem in by using the greedy approach, and these two algorithms are given basically specified in your syllabus. First one is Kruskal algorithm, that is created in 1957 by Joseph Kruskal, and some more algorithm here, Prim's algorithm, that is created by Robert C. Prim. Both are algorithms. We are saying that why we are learning these two old algorithms, but still people are doing research on these two algorithm basically, and find out some more flavors and more speed up or some more efficient algorithm or some more flavor of Kruskal, some more flavor of Prim's algorithm, efficient, more efficient Prim's algorithm, more efficient Kruskal algorithm. But as a fundamental, we should have to know how these two algorithms are, because these are very basic algorithms, and we have to require to find out we have to discuss and understand these two algorithms, and then we can also develop our own algorithm for find out the minimum cost spanning tree. Okay, still people are doing PhD, doing research, MTech research, PhD research by using the Kruskal and Prim's algorithm on different application of network as well as IoT or using the artificial intelligence also. Okay, so we model the situation as a network. This one is the same problem. Then the problem is to find minimum connector for the network. Okay. And we have to require to find out the minimum connector for the network. Kruskal algorithm. Okay. List the edges in order of the size. Okay. Very first, what we have to require, because this is the prerequisite for this algorithm. Right side, in the right side of this graph, we are seeing list the edges in the order of the size. Means we arrange the edges. A set, capital A set, in them we have to require to sort. Sort means you can apply any of the sorting algorithm, quick sort algorithm, insertion sort algorithm, bubble sort algorithm, to sort the array A basically. Okay, and list the edges in order of the size. Okay, so initially we'll take, that means we'll just arrange in ascending order on the cost of the, as per the cost of the edge basically. So very first we'll put very first edge in the array ED, because it contain minimum cost 2, AV that contain minimum cost 3, AE that minimum cost 4. Okay, so this is the ascending order. We'll arrange the set array A in sorting. This is because this is a prerequisite for this algorithm. After that, select the shortest edge in the network. Okay, you select the shortest edge in the network. Okay, and then we'll ED, because it will contain the minimum cost edge. Next, we'll select AB. It does not create a cycle, because AB is not does not create a cycle, means that we can choose this AB as a selection vector. Then we'll select either CD or AE. So very first we'll choose CD, then we'll select AE. Okay. Next minimum cost is we have BC. Okay, this one is the minimum cost is, but it's creating a cycle. And that I told earlier that a graph tree does not contain any of the cycles, so we'll not consider this is in our solution vector. We just ignore. Means every time when we select the minimum cost is, we should have to check every time whether it is creating a cycle or not. If it, any is creating a cycle, then we'll just ignore this is. If not creating the cycle, then we'll select this is in our solution vector. Okay. Next, we have EF. Again, it is not creating the cycle, so we'll select this in our solution vector. next from here we can see that as all the vertices have been connected, so we just stop here, okay, because this is our destination, the final approach to connect all the vertices, and then we will find out the total weight of the tree from the age cost of the selected edges, which is from equals to 18. 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 4 plus 5 is equals to 18. Next, we'll see again, this one is the graphical representation of this algorithm. So we should have to write down the algorithm by using some notation, basically. So, because that is very important, this skill should be known with the IT professional, as you should have to know how to write the algorithm, basically. Okay. So, Kruskal algorithms, basically, in which as a name of this algorithm that have a Kruskal input, required some input. Input is what? Graph G, that contain two sets, graph set N, a set of vertex, set A that contain edges of this graph. Okay. And initially, that is very important that I have told earlier, for this algorithm, Kruskal algorithm, what it is required? It required to sort the array A by increasing length. That is very important. Means when we implement the program, we'll call some sorting algorithm, any of the sorting algorithm, quick sort, any of the sorting algorithm will call for the array A and sort this array A in increasing length. And then one by one, we will select minimum cost is by just checking whether it is creating a cycle or not. This is the Kruskal algorithm basically. So initially, sort A by increasing the length and the number of nodes in the N, T. Okay, T is initially contain 5 because it's the solution vector. As we know that set in the set theory, then set does not contain any element, then it is denoted by 5. Okay, so T initially contain 5. Okay, next we will apply greedy loop. Okay, so we'll repeat. We repeat until T contain N minus 1 edges. Means solution vector T. Initially T contain 5. Okay, so we'll repeat this these steps up to when until T contain N minus 1 edges. Okay, clear. Because as we know that a tree contain how many edges? If n is the number of vertices in a tree, then total number of edges may contain n minus 1. Okay, so we'll repeat this process up to n minus 1 edges. Okay, so initially in that particular loop, E is contain initially UV. That is the shortest is not yet considered. Means is will select that is shortest is that minimum cost is, but not yet considered. Okay, so we'll select this. Like suppose U and T. Okay. Now, question is that we know that we select the minimum cost A, but we have to require to check whether this A is creating a cycle or not. So, how can we check this? As we know that find is one of the algorithms that you have discussed in data structure also. So, find is one of the algorithms to find out the adjacency nodes. Okay. What? Adjacency nodes. Okay. Just a minute. Adjacency nodes. Okay, means find is one of the function that find the adjacency node of any node. Basically, means find U means U means find U means it find the all the vertices that these are the neighbor of the U. Basically, okay. So that will be stored in U compare, and after that, in the next step, we'll find the neighbor of and adjacency nodes of B, find B, and will result will be stored in B compare. Why we are doing this? Because we know that concept is what, if neighbor of U and neighbor of V are not common, then what will happen? If they are not common, means they are not creating any cycle. If any of the neighbor are common in selected A vertexes U and V, then what will happen? That may be happen that what will happen? That is a chance that there is that selected A may create cycle. Okay, जो selected A's आपने select कर लिए, that वो क्या create कर सकती है? एक cycle create करेगी. But जब साइकिल क्रिएट करेगी देन अल्टीमेटली वी डोंट हैव टू रिक्वायर टू सेलेक्ट, वी जस्ट हैव टू इग्नोर दिस फेज. ओके, हाउएवर इट इज शॉर्टेज इज बेसिकली मिनिमम कॉस्टिंग, बट इफ इट इज क्रिएटिंग एनी साइकिल देन वी विल इग्नोर दिस थिंग. हाउ कैन वी फाइंड आउट whether it is creating a cycle or not? By just check, find out the, all the neighbors of selected instances. Means find U means all the neighbor of U. Find V means find all the neighbor of V. And then check. Compare. U compare is not equals to V compare. Next step, we are checking any common, if they are equal to, if any common they have, no. Means that there are no, it's not creating any cycle. Okay, if it is equal, then it creates a cycle. So we ignore. If it is not creating any cycle, if U compare is not equals to V compare, then merge U compare and V compare. And then in the solution vector, what we are doing, we just merge in the solution vector, we include this T union E, means the set T. अंदर आप क्या और इंक्लूड कर देंगे, सेलेक्टेड इज ई, दैट इज मिनिमम कॉस्ट इज एज वेल एज इट इज नॉट क्रिएटिंग एनी साइकिल. ओके, एंड वी विल रिपीट दिस प्रोसेस अप टू एन माइनस वन इज इज इट टू बी कंटेन हाउ मेनी इज एन माइनस वन. ओके, एंड आफ्टर दैट दिस एल्गोरिथम फाइनली रिटर्न ई. टी इज द सॉल्यूशन मींस एरे दैट कंटेन ऑल द इजेस, दीज आर मिनिमम कॉस्ट इजेस as well as are not creating any cycle, and also when we connect these array, then it creates a tree. This is minimum cost spanning tree. So this is the Kruskal algorithm. In the next slide, we'll discuss, we'll see what is the time complexity of that Kruskal algorithm is basically. Okay, we know that sorting algorithm, suppose we are using any quick sort algorithm, then what is the time complexity of quick sort algorithm and log n. Okay, initialization of compound, because there are a total number of n nodes, so initialization required big O n. Finding and merging, because this loop is used basically, from here we can see the repeat and until t contain n minus 1 needed. This loop is working up to means finding the minimum neighbor, okay, and then merging. This process include that required the time complexity n log n. Okay, now we are that we have discussed earlier in the quick sort algorithm, that how to compute the time complexity of any of the algorithms. This is similarly from here, you can just find out in your notebook to how it is coming, because n log n. Okay, and finally from here we can see that which one is the dominating in out of these three time complexity, n log n. So what is the time complexity of Kruskal algorithm is n log n. Okay, so today's class is we'll discuss up to here. In the next class, we'll discuss about the Prim's algorithm and its time complexity. Okay, clear? I'm just ending the meeting. Anybody have query, then you can write down in you can communicate through mail and WhatsApp also. Okay, thank you.